Hello, good morning friends. We will start with a new class. In our previous classes we have looked some points related to digestion, absorption and metabolism of lipids. In today's class we will see some points related to deficiency of lipid and excessiveness of lipids. These are the most related to disorder and disease related. We will start with the heading Lipid Deficiency and Lipid Excessiveness. Here some of the diseases or disorders we are listed here are deficiency related. When the deficiency of lipid happen means recommended dietary allowance for the lipid range is less than requirement. Normal range of lipid requirement is per day requirement is on an average 20 to 30 for adult. 20 to 30 gram of fat we should be consuming every day to be a healthy person. If the consumption of the lipid is less means it will be leads to deficiency disorders. Usually deficiency of fat is less commonly happen. Excessiveness is more commonly happen. Some of the rare cases of deficiency of this lipids we have discussed here, which are those means first one is the growth failure. Failure of growth or growth failure. Here, if the calorie requirement and energy requirement is less for the growing children, growing milestones are going to become delay in nature. Slow growth and development is happen in a preschooler or school-going children. It is one of the deficiency disorders related to fat. And second one, dry skin or dermatitis. It is more commonly related to deficiency of essential fatty acids. Usually we are seen in the previous class, the deficiency of essential fatty acids leads to prinoderma or tarred skin. That is characterized by horny eruption of the skin, horny or rough eruption of the skin at the lateral and back portion, posterior aspect of buttocks and limbs. Same like if the deficiency of essential fatty acids or lipids leads to dermatitis or dryness of skin. And skin will lose its shining. And next one, there is a loss of hair. Hair loss is more common in deficiency of essential fatty acids. Along with that, vitamin E deficiency also leads to loss of hair. And next one, there is a delay in wound healing. Decreased process of wound healing is commonly will be seen in a deficiency of lipids. And decrease mental development. Mental development is more commonly happening after the attainment of second year. If the baby's age period is 2 years, during that time central nervous system is going to become faster in their functioning and growth and development. Along with faster growth and development of this central nervous system and peripheral nervous system, we require lipids for formation of myelin sheath over the neuronal cells. That's why if the deficiency of essential fatty acids or any pupa containing fatty acids, it will be harms to mental development also. Okay, that's why these are the deficiency disorder related to lipids, which are those growth failure, dry skin, dermatitis, hair loss, delay in wound healing or decreased mental developmental process. Okay. Next we will be see some points related to excessiveness of fat. If you are consuming more than 30 grams per day and your caloric intake is more than normal intake and being as a sedentary lifestyle person and consuming excessive alcohol. During that time, there is an excessive deposition of fat in a subcutaneous layer and other part of the body. Okay, And in this condition, excess immunoglobulin first and prior disorder happen here is, that is obesity. When will be said as obesity? If the individual BMI, body mass index, is more than 25, will be called as overweight. More than 30, first grade obesity. Okay, as the grade increases, obesity related diseases also increases. And some of the other diseases related to obesity and excessive fat deposition in body, which are those means heart diseases. Heart disease as a result of, if the excessive fat is there in body, that condition will be called as a hyperlipidemia state. Total cholesterol rate is, total cholesterol level is increases. Other lipoprotein level is also going to increases. Free fatty acid level is going to increase. During that time, excessive fat is going to deposited at the arterial wall, inner wall of the inner layer of the arteries. That process will be called as a atherosclerosis. This atherosclerosis usually happen in a coronary artery and carotid artery. It happen in a coronary artery, it will cause myocardial infarction or myocardial infraction. It will be, it may be leads to heart failure, and it may be causes severe angina pain. And if this atherosclerosis happen in a carotid artery, it may cause stroke. There is a decreased blood supply to the brain cells. The person can be gone to the condition of coma also. And next one, fatty liver. If there is a imbalance between the saturated fat and unsaturated fat, or excessive consumption of trans fat, and that person cannot be consuming pupa containing fatty acids, polyunsaturated fatty acids he cannot be consuming, means there is a deficiency of that lipoproteins, formation of lipoproteins. What is the main function of lipoprotein? Means those will be helping for the transportation of lipids from liver to periphery or periphery to liver. In case of deficiency of these lipoproteins, there is no transportation of lipids stored in the liver. As much as the lipid is stored in the liver, being within the liver, and excessive deposition leads to fatty liver. And these will be lead to further several complications related to fatty liver. And next one, stroke. As we are discussed, there is a atherosclerosis and atheroma formation in a carotid artery. That will be blocked the blood supply into the brain. And usually person can go under the coma state and convulsion state. Finally, death can be happen. And next one is hypertension. As a result of atherosclerosis, narrowing of arterial wall, it will be increases the blood pressure. If the narrowing of the arterial wall will be, what it will be cause? The pressure exerted over the blood is increases. And the normal blood pressure is 120 by 80. But in case of hypertension, blood pressure is more than 140 by 80 or more than 140 by 90 will be coming. That is one of the causes related to excessiveness of fat. And next one is diabetes mellitus. Type 2 diabetes mellitus means age related diabetes mellitus is more common as a result of excessive consumption of fat. Next one is, there is a problem with the joints, mobility problems, joint problems, arthritis, and walking problem, and some of stiffness in the joint will be arise. And the next one, respiratory problems. If the obese person is there, his BMI rate is also increases, along with some diaphragmatic movement will be become hampered or problematic. For that reason, there is a existence of breathing problems. Okay, these are the list of disorder or diseases related to excessiveness of lipids, which are those: obesity, heart disease, fatty liver, stroke, hypertension, diabetes mellitus, joint problem, respiratory problems. Even though thrombophlebitis can be happen, these are disorder or disease related to fat. Finally, we will be conclude one more time: lipid deficiency diseases, excessiveness diseases. Which are those deficiency diseases? Means first one is growth failure, dry skin, hair loss, decreased wound healing process, decreased mental development. These are deficiency. Excessiveness, obesity, heart disease, fatty liver, stroke, hypertension, diabetes mellitus, joint problems, respiratory problems. These are excessiveness of fat. By this we will be complete today class. In upcoming class we will be discuss some points related to next unit, fourth unit, that is protein. Bye. Thank you so much.